The effects browser is our shortcut to be able to explore the over 4,000 presets that we have available to us in the Continuum package. But it's more than just a way of looking at presets. So join me as we take a look at the effects browser. So the effects browser is the way that we preview all of the presets available to us within a certain effect. And as we know, presets are a great way of saving time with an effect or deciding what kind of style we want if we are looking for some inspiration. So with this clip, I'm going to use a video glitch. I'm going to use video glitch RT and place this over my car park clip. And under the effect editor, we have all of our presets available in this drop-down menu. But more importantly, we also have this show effects browser. And if I click on this, it opens up the effects browser window. So we have our big preview window in the right-hand side. And I can resize this just by dragging around. And I can change things up at the top, such as the playback quality, so we can be working with proxies to get faster playback. Yeah, I'll keep this at half. And we can choose how effects with alpha channels are going to be composited over. Are we going to see them over black, with a checkerboard, or over our background clip? And we also have a compare functionality, so I can look at the original on the left-hand side. And as we play this back here, I can look at the affected clip on the right-hand side. And if I play this through once, the video will cache in and then play back faster the second time around. At the bottom of the viewer, I can choose and control how much of the original clip that we're playing back, just using the in and out points over here. And as you can see, as it's playing back this the first time, it will also cache in these new frames. Once it's cached, I can go over to the presets in the left-hand side and then just start clicking through. And you'll see that it doesn't have to cache the original video anymore. It'll just play back the effect as fast as it can. Once again, getting faster the second time around as we get real-time playback. So now I can figure out which one of these effects is going to suit what I'm after or be close enough so I can come and customize it back in Media Composer. So let's turn our compare off here. I'm going to hit apply. And now you can see we have our effect playing back in Media Composer. And I can, of course, still customize all the parameters, either using the heads-up display controls or coming over to the effect editor and changing the controls over here instead. We come to our second clip now. Sometimes I won't even know what I'm doing with a particular shot. Maybe I'll know the style of the effect that I'm looking for, but not the effect itself, or possibly I'm just searching for inspiration. And in this case, what I can do is use the effects browser filter, either on the clip itself or on a filler layer. And when I come into the effects browser now, it won't just show me the presets I have available, it will show me all of the BCC filters that I have available. So if I know I want to change the colors up a little bit, maybe I'll go with one of the color corrections here. I can take a look at some of these interesting ones with the multi-tone mix or with a tritone, or I can come over to something like the film styles and look at the fast film process, for example. I can see how any of these effects or presets are going to work on my particular piece of footage. Now, if you'll see down in the bottom right, we don't have apply and close as we did when we were working with a filter itself. We just have close because the effects browser doesn't let us apply a particular filter or preset, but it just lets us know what we've got available to us. So now I can come in and I can go fast film process, bring that over onto my clip. And when I come back into the effects browser, I can actually see a history of the last presets that I've used, or more to the point, the last presets that I clicked on. So if we're clicking around, we find something that we sort of like here, which is the old Super 8 color, and maybe we start looking a bit further. I can just go back into my history and say, oh, actually, it was the old Super 8 color that I was after, and then hit apply. And that gives me my preset that, again, I can come in and customize as I need to. And that's a quick look about how we use the effects browser in Boris Continuum within Avid Media Composer. If you found this video useful, then remember to hit the like button. For more ways to master Boris Continuum in Avid, subscribe to the Boris FX YouTube channel and check out our other tutorials. If we're missing something, then let me know in the comments below. My name's Ben Brownlee from Boris FX, and thanks for watching.